Okay.
Yes!
Okay.
Yes! I've been practicing all morning. Well, we're still locked in. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show, of course, guys. And now with the UEFA Europa and Champions League finals over, the weekend definitely inspired our hashtag Wednesday workout with this regular size soccer ball. Now, when it comes to children, of course, one of the best ways to keep them in shape, if, regardless of the season, I think, is through a full body workout and a full body exercise, I think, and kind of tricking them into having fun at the same time. So this morning's soccer ball workout is designed for kids, not only who will provide them with a fun and effective full body workout, but it's also going to teach them a little bit about coordination and ball mastery. So of course, grab your soccer ball and join us for this hashtag Wednesday workout. And I'm joined by the beautiful Jamie Lee Dumberg. So Jamie, I've got to say, listening to your chat earlier with the counselor, I think it was so interesting to raise a point which I think is going to serve and solve a problem you discussed earlier, and that's kids going to schools not having the opportunity to play like they used to, not having the opportunity to express themselves, especially when it comes to the physical expression. And we know kids have so much energy when it comes to being at a younger age, and they're growing, and they just want to, you just want to go, you just want to dance. So this is a great opportunity for you to get involved with the kids as well, to give them that opportunity to express themselves physically, and also they're going to benefit from the skills, the hand-eye coordination, motor functioning skills, and everything else that comes with that. So we're going to have some fun this morning, of course, as we normally do, and we're using a soccer ball. As always, guys, you don't have to use a soccer ball. You can find any ball that you have at home. So whether it's just a light plastic inflatable ball, you're still going to benefit from it. Hockey ball, you can maybe make it work. It's a little bit too small, though, but let's get into it, guys. Okay. Let's get involved. All right, so we're starting off with everything as we normally do with a cardio session, right? And cardio is just to get warm. It's also a nice opportunity to have fun. So we're going to drop the ball straight on the ground now.
Right, I just want to let you guys know that I am modifying, so in case you can't keep up with Raul, because I feel like you never...
I think you're going to get this. You're going to nail it, right? So it's nice and simple. It's just making sure that we've got control of the ball, and we're also going to stay off of our heels. So staying on the forefoots of our toes is going to work the calves quite a bit. We're running on the spot, and we're just tapping the ball and trying to keep it in the center. So you might have seen myself and Kat start off with a warm-up like this when we did the adult version of this workout. But try your very best to keep that ball just in front of you and keep tapping it, and that's going to allow you to force that control. But of course, Jamie, try your very best to stay off those heels, and that's going to force your calves to work a little bit. Of course, the kids don't need to worry about that. They can just have fun and benefit from all the cardio efforts that are going in here. So 30 seconds of cardio done, and then we're moving over into our first exercise, which is quite a fun one. It's like a modified burpee in a sense, but we're just having fun with it. We're forcing the upper body to come into play. We're forcing the entire body to work. Why are you smiling like that?
Do you know what? Before I even knew you going through this workout, I knew you're going to put a burpee in there
somewhere.
Yeah,
you're going to sneak in burpees.
It's like, put in a burpee. Oh, my word.
It's like the best exercise ever, right? So what we're going to do is use the ball to support yourself when you're basing on the ground, right? So we go down into a little bit of a squat, nice hinge. When the ball's down on the ground, this is where the stability comes into play. So the kids are going to have fun trying to stay up top on this. And then you shoot your legs back. And then you're going to just step forward nice and easy. Lift the ball all the way up to the sky. And then bring it straight back down again.
Love this one.
Shoot them back. Nice. And then step forward. And then bring it all the way up to the sky. So what we're doing is we're working that posterior and anterior chain with the kids as well. Ooh. Also getting functional movement. And of course, we are burning calories like you cannot imagine. And while using the ball for stability, that's really going to assist you in just making sure that the shoulders don't pop out. They get nice and strong and stable. And they are secure in the sockets. So we're back over. That was cardio exercise. Now we're going back to cardio. So this cardio is a little bit more tricky. So we're going to put some skills to this now. It's called a step over in soccer. Disky 99, you know all the things. So what we're going to do is you're going to step over the ball to your right-hand side. And as you do so, you're going to stand in a diver position. All right, so you're forcing that glute to fire. Then roll over to the other side. Diver position again. All right, so 30 seconds. Step overs. Keep that diver. So left foot, right foot goes to the right-hand side, and you're staying nice and stable. You're not putting the other foot on the ground, and you'll feel those glutes starting to burn. You feeling it?
Feeling it.
And of course, you've got to keep your eyes on the ball. If you want to, you guys can go faster, make it quicker, and make it more dynamic. The more that you get used to this, and you're going to feel a proper burn indeed. How are you feeling?
I'm sweating. Like,
all right, so you pick the ball straight after that. So it's 30 seconds. It's just full of fun, full of chaos, full of movement. And we're going to get down into this. So now we're going to do something called basketball jumps. Michael Jordan in the building. The Bulls, if anybody doesn't know about Michael Jordan, great basketball player. So you're jumping in the sky, trying to get as much air time as you can before going straight back down to the ground. And it's going to load that back leg quite a bit. Make sure the heels are not on the ground this time. Jumping in the air, shoot, and then straight back down. shoot, and then straight back down, shoot, and then straight back down. These exercises are tough, I'm not gonna lie, all right? So if you can't do 30 seconds of intense movement, just hold on for as long as you can, all right?
You did not come out to play this morning. This is like a Wednesday workout
it's
of
been
note.
Weeks and weeks and weeks of kids being confined to small spaces, so here's the opportunity to them to just have a load of fun. All right, so while we finish off, last exercise in the building, it's a big lunge, jump to the side, throw the ball down, and then switching over. And you're going for your 30 seconds to finish off. And of course, guys, get the kids involved. Make some magic. Have some fun. And of course, use anything that you have in the home. Energy is required to do these workouts.
Just throw the kid around, like, yes, go, Luca.
Have a beautiful one, guys. Hope you enjoyed the session. Let us know what your thoughts are. And of course, shake and bake. Stay tuned for some more magic.